confession. Please join me in welcoming another Catholic in the room, Toastmaster Daniel Dominguez.
I'm David Esposito, fellow Toastmasters, presiding officer, most welcome guest. I'm very excited to be here tonight. Tonight I'm going to tell you about my passions. It's going to be a story of successes, failures, missteps, mistakes. I'm going to tell you about how I came to where I am in my career right now. A lot of times I look back and I wonder, if I could take the same steps over again to get to where I am today, could I have? How much of it was intentional, and how much of it was fate, if you believe in fate. So let's start from the beginning. I graduated college. I had not looked for a job. My last semester was 17 credits, and I was completely overloaded with classwork, and I was just concentrating on graduating. So I told myself, I'm just gonna wait until I graduate. I'll move back in with mom, and I'll find a job. So that's what I did. I got a job at a company locally called Motorola. I think we even have a few Motorolans in the room. Hand raises, we had two at least. And I loved it. I loved working there. I loved what I did. And not too many people can say that. I've always loved taking apart toys, micro machines. I loved micro machines as a kid. Legos, Lincoln blocks, Mr. Wizard, who I credit for being an engineer even today. And I was there for almost 8 years. And admittedly, it was not a great time for Motorola. Over the years, we had lost more and more market share and didn't really seem to have a good plan on how to regain our lost footing. And after surviving waves upon waves of layoffs, I decided that I didn't want a job where I was more concerned about losing my job than the details of my job. I thought I was going to take my fate into my own hands. So I found another job and I left. I left for a company called CrossMatch, located up in Palm Beach Gardens. It was a really great opportunity. They make fingerprint and iris scanners for military, and they also have some public sector products. For example, if you've ever flown into Miami from out of the country, they have fingerprint scanners right at the customs desk. Those are CrossMatch. It's a great opportunity. I was one of three mechanical engineers. It was a small company, a lot of room to grow. But much like a Shakespearean tragedy where the protagonist learns about his fate and tries so hard to outrun it that he actually runs into it, I was there for 6 months and they laid me off. It was less inconvenient time because I was getting married in 3 months. But the show must go on. The wedding date stayed, and I decided to dig in my heels. I made looking for a job my job. I woke up every day, showered, I got my clothes on, and I got out the door. I got to a Starbucks, I got to a library, anywhere with Wi-Fi that I could look for a job. And eventually, I even swallowed my pride. I swallowed my pride and I tried to go back to Motorola. I interviewed there twice, never heard back from them. Finally, I go to a picnic one day, and I run into an old friend of mine who was at the time a manager at BlackBerry. And he learned that I was out of a job. He said, Daniel, we could use a guy like you. I'm not gonna lie, BlackBerry's not doing great. If you had a job, I wouldn't tell you to come over, but you don't. So come on in, the interview's yours to screw up. And so I went there, and I interviewed, and I got the job. I was gainfully employed there for a year, and wasn't really a step forward in my career, and I look back at the time many times regretting that I left Motorola. I remember telling my wife it was the worst career decision I had made. Now follow me, because this next series of events kind of happens quickly. I eventually do hear back from Motorola. It wasn't to tell me that I got the job. It wasn't to tell me that I didn't get the job. It was to tell me that they never contacted me because they're closing their doors. Anybody who knows or has been following the news knows that they're closed down. There were only about 300 people left, and they were all left without a job. Kind of ironically, I would have ended up in that same position anyhow, and I was doing better off at BlackBerry than most of my peers. Right around that same time, I received a call from a former manager of mine, Paul. He said, "Listen, would you be interested in coming to a small startup? I can't tell you what they do, but let's get together for some beers and we'll talk about some opportunities." And admittedly, even after talking to him, interviewing, and even accepting the job, I really didn't know quite what I was getting into. But Paul's the type of manager that you follow. And that's how I ended up at Magic Leap. I was employee number 100. We have 500 employees right now. In Florida, Boston, California, we're growing very quickly. I can't tell you what we do, but it's really cool stuff. And I'm happy to be where I am today. Thank you.